Welcome to this short video from the FFG Academy on the topic Horizon Europe and Structure. EU research framework programs have existed since 1984. The political objectives and principles of the framework programs are laid down in the Treaty on the Functioning of the European Union. The first EU framework program just over 40 years ago had a budget of 3.8 billion euros. A lot has changed since then. The current framework program already has 95 billion euros, making it the world's largest single funding program for research and innovation. The overarching goal of European research policy is the creation of a common European research area. To achieve this, the EU promotes collaborations between companies, research institutions, and universities in Europe, also globally, with the aim of advancing excellent research and cutting-edge technological developments and supporting groundbreaking innovations. Important thematic areas include climate neutrality and digitalization, promoting health, climate, and environmental research, and of course, industrial innovations and strengthening social resilience. Horizon Europe is embedded in various other EU European programs. The Horizon Europe specific program consists of three major program pillars, as well as a fourth overarching area. Each pillar is further divided into different program areas, which I will discuss in more detail later. It is important to emphasize that the funding here is focused exclusively on civil applications. The first pillar is entitled Excellent Science. The second pillar is dedicated to global challenges at European industrial competitiveness. This also includes the newly introduced EU missions and various European partnerships. This means public-private partnerships, for example, between the European Commission and various industry associations. The third pillar is called Innovative Europe. It focuses primarily on the economy, but scientific organizations can also participate. The last cross-sectional area shown below is about strengthening the European research area. An important distinction between the different programs is the different approaches between top-down or bottom-up. Top-down means that the topics are determined from the top or above, in this case by the European Commission. As an applicant, you can only apply for call topics and must therefore first screen whether there are any suitable calls for proposals for your research area. Top-down calls are found primarily in Pillar 2, including in the missions and partnerships, but also partly in other pillars, for example, in research infrastructures or the EIC Pathfinder. In contrast, the bottom-up calls are thematically open, so you as the applicant can choose the research area yourself. But of course, you still have to follow the rules and conditions of the respective funding instruments. Bottom-up calls are mainly found in Pillar 1, excellence programs, and in Pillar 3, for example, in the European Innovation Council. Another important distinction not shown here in color is whether the programs are open to individual applicants or whether collaborative projects are mandatory, meaning that consortia of multiple European partners must submit proposals. You can find more information on this in our online information package. Now a quick overview of the individual pillars. We start with Pillar 1, Excellent Science, with the main objective, strengthening and expanding the excellence of the scientific base. There's a total budget of 25 billion euros. The majority of the programs are thematically open, so bottom up, but not all. The Open Theme European Research Council, or ERC, supports outstanding researchers at all stages of their careers, so that they and their teams can conduct groundbreaking research projects at the frontiers of knowledge. The sole evaluation criteria is scientific excellence. The highly competitive program includes four central funding lines, These differ depending on how long after the doctorate you can apply and in their funding amount. The Marie Skłodowska Career Actions, or MSCA, are primarily focused on promoting the career development of researchers through transnational mobility, but also on improving collaboration between universities, companies, and other organizations. The most important funding programs are the doctoral training networks, international networks for the training of doctoral students, and also the postdoctoral fellowships, personalized research projects for experienced individual researchers with a completed doctorate, for example, postdocs, who can conduct their projects both within and outside of Europe. The Research Infrastructure Program is about developing new research infrastructures in Europe and strengthening existing ones. It also aims to provide better access to these infrastructures. Examples you may have already heard of can be found on this slide. Now to Pillar 2, Global Challenges and European Industrial Competitiveness. As a reminder, this pillar, which has a budget of 53.5 billion euros, primarily implements the following Horizon Europe objectives: supporting and disseminating high-quality knowledge, technologies, and sustainable solutions, as well as strengthening European industrial competitiveness. This is implemented through six thematic clusters, some of which combine different areas from previous programs, for example, in Cluster 5, Climate, Energy, Mobility. All clusters are implemented through annual work programs with one or more calls for proposals, which clearly define the topics for which projects can be submitted. On the following slides, hidden in this presentation, you will find keywords for the broad thematic coverage of the clusters. The EU missions, which were first introduced with Horizon Europe, are also assigned to the second pillar. The EU missions are new EU-wide research and innovation instruments that aim to address ambitious goals to address current societal challenges in Europe in an interdisciplinary manner. The missions are divided into five thematic areas, the so-called mission areas, namely climate change, cancer, healthy oceans and waters, cities and soil, health and food. Each mission area has set an overarching ambitious goal at the beginning. For example, the goal of the soil health mission is by 2030, at least 75% of all soils in the EU are healthy. On the cities area, by 2030, there will be 100 climate neutral cities. The EU missions are ultimately implemented through normal calls once a year, just like the calls in the six clusters. Now to the third main pillar, Innovative Europe. The European Innovation Council, or EIC, aims to bring innovations to the market more quickly and thereby create growth and jobs. The EIC aims to pave the way for radically new, groundbreaking products, services, processes, and business models. The funding instruments are mostly thematically open and offer scope for interdisciplinary ideas. In addition to technological innovations, non-technological innovations, such as social innovations or innovations in the service sector, can also be supported. There are three main programs based on the technology readiness level. The EIC Pathfinder supports the earliest stages of scientific and technological research and development of future breakthrough market-creating technologies and/or deep tech technologies. The EIC Transition offers the opportunity to further develop promising results from the EIC Pathfinder and certain ERC projects. Lastly, the EIC Accelerator bridges the gap between late-stage research and innovation activities and market entry. It provides growth financing for companies with highly innovative solutions that lack adequate financing on the market. The European Institute of Innovation and Technology, EIT, was established in 2008 and is an independent institution of the European Union. Although it is formally assigned to Pillar 3 of Horizon Europe, it's not part of the Horizon Europe specific program. The EIT brings together leading companies, education and research organizations in cross-border partnerships or knowledge and innovation communities, also called EIT communities. The aim here is also to strengthen competitiveness and to jointly develop solutions to important European challenges. Explore the website to find the EIT community that best fits your area of interest. There you will find details on open calls, programs, events, and various opportunities to get involved. Finally, a brief insight into the last cross-cutting area, also called Pillar 4, widening participation and strengthening the European research area. This part of the program, which has a budget of 3.4 billion euros, is often abbreviated with VIDERA. On the one hand, this involves targeted funding lines for countries that have so far been less active or successful in the field of research and innovation, the so-called widening countries. On the other hand, it involves reforming and strengthening the European research area, or ERA for short, meaning further expanding and strengthening ERA. This concludes the brief overview of Horizon Europe. Thank you for listening, and I wish you every success with your projects.